It's incredible how many times I see the question, can my Mac run Sierra? I see it on forums, discussion boards, Apple site, other sites, everywhere. It's pretty easy to figure this out. Apple has a whole page dedicated just to this. If you go to this page here, you'll come here to how to get macOS Sierra. You don't have to remember this URL or even type it. Notice that if I were to copy and paste just the words, how to get macOS Sierra, into search bar here, it comes up right away as the top result. And here is where you can find out all the information. At the top here it says whether or not your Mac can use Sierra. And it has all this these models of Mac here. And you can see it says things like, for instance, Mac Pro mid 2010 or newer. How do you find out what your Mac is? Well, if you go to About This Mac up here, it tells you like Mac Pro late 2013. So it uses the same vocabulary here to tell you whether or not you can use Sierra. A common question people have is, well, I've got a slightly older Mac, but I've upgraded it. I've added more memory, things like that. It doesn't matter. You need these Macs with those processors and chipsets in them in order to run Sierra. You may have a lot of memory, but maybe you don't have the correct Bluetooth chips or Wi-Fi or GPU, all sorts of things. So it's got to be one of these or Sierra simply won't install. So if you've determined that your Mac does qualify, how do you get to run Sierra? Well, you should have gotten a notification. You can see down here below it even gives an example here, a notification saying it's time to upgrade to Sierra. If you've ignored that or maybe didn't remember seeing that, you can get instructions right here. You can go to the App Store, that's where you get it, and you can search for Sierra. There's even a link right here on the page to go directly to the purchase page for Sierra. Of course, it's free, so by purchasing it means just basically downloading and getting things going. The only other things that you need to know is that you need to have, as it says here, at least 2 GB of memory and 8.8 gigs of storage space. Now you're almost certainly going to have 2 GB of memory if you have any of these Macs, though it's possible in some of the earlier models here to have less. And also the storage space, it's just a matter of having enough storage space for you to download the software for it to extract and then install. You don't have to have that left over when you're done, but you need to have it during the installation process. And that's basically all you need to know. Everything else is explained here on that page. And if you can get Sierra on your Mac, you should be able to get it. Update has been out for a long time now and has all the latest features. So check out this page for more information.